So maybe you've noticed that I've been doing a lot of these videos about best editors for PDFs. And the reason why is because I got so frustrated with Adobe. I signed up for their monthly plan, thinking it's a monthly plan, but actually it was an annual plan paid monthly. So when I tried to cancel it after a couple of months, because I don't need to edit PDFs daily for like 8 hours, just from time to time I need to edit something in a PDF, and so very sporadically. And so when I tried to cancel it, I was getting a message about that I'm going to have to pay a cancellation fee. And the cancellation fee was like close to $100. So I was like, wait a minute, what's going on? I thought I had signed up for monthly plan. So I made a mistake. And so I want to go over some of the pricing with Adobe and how it works and in what cases you can be charged cancellation fee, depending on which plan you choose. Let's just go over some of the stuff so you don't make the same mistake I made. And I am actually doing these reviews because I want to find a good editor, PDF editor that I can use from time to time if I need a couple of PDFs to edit, but I just don't want to commit to something that I have to pay annual subscription or pay $30 for a month to edit a couple PDFs. So let me show you like some of the information. It's very hard to find on their account. So this is, if you go to account.adobe.com, you get to your account information. And here it tells me, okay, this is my plan and showing me all these applications I'm getting. And I'm actually just getting pretty much Acrobat Pro because Adobe Scan is free, Acrobat Reader is free, and Acrobat DC Standard is only available for Windows, so I can't use it. They're, you know, trying to make it look like you're getting so much better deal because you're getting multiple applications, but it's really the Acrobat Pro that I needed. I'm going to click on the Manage My Plan right there. And here, and I want to just point this out because I went through multiple times all these account sections trying to figure out where does it say since when till when is my contract. Here is the only place that I found that it says since when I'm with this plan, which is March 18, 2022. That means to me that probably March 18, 2023 will be the end of it. Now, I was not able to find anywhere that it said that I'm going to be automatically subscribed or anything going to be renewed, hopefully. But the thing is, I don't trust the system anymore because how I made that mistake by signing up for this annual plan when I thought it was just a monthly plan. Now, this rate was something that I negotiated because I actually signed up like in January, made that mistake, and after 2 months and being charged, and I tried to cancel, that's when I got that service fee, cancellation fee showing up for me, and I called them, I tried to like tell them, wait a minute, I don't want this plan, and so they gave me a better rate, but I still was not able to completely cancel it. Now, if you go here, and now if you try to say, let's cancel my plan, and once you get there, you can specify why you're canceling. So I'm going to say it's too expensive and I only need it occasionally, and you can provide more information. And this, it says annual plan paid monthly. And here it says, but it does not specify. That's what's frustrating to me. When would it end? It's just not very transparent to the customers. So I click continue and it's asking me, do you want to switch products or change some part of your current plan? I said, no, thanks. And at this point, this is when I see this cancellation fee. And so right now it's $750 only because I'm actually almost like a month away from the end of my contract. Now, if you click this learn more, Adobe provides information about the cancellation fee. So the cancellation fee is only applicable to the annual plan that's paid monthly. So when you click at the very top here, it shows you the annual plan paid monthly. It says within 14 days, it's free. You have no fee charged if you cancel within 14 days, if it's your first time signing up for it. Now, after 14 days, a cancellation fee is applicable. And now you will have to scroll down and it shows you how the cancellation fee is calculated. And it depends whether you have multiple or one app, and I have just one app. So here is an example of how much would be the cancellation fee depending when you cancel. So you can see, for example, let's say if you have a application monthly subscription fee of $20.99 because it depends on your subscription, and let's say I have $14.99 because I negotiated at the time when I called in frustrated that I signed up inadvertently for this plan. So if you're paying this much, then let's see if you cancel in month 4, it'd be $83.96 would be the cancellation fee. At the very top, if you click on the annual plan prepaid, there is no refund. Basically, if you pay that one time, that's it. You have no way to get a refund. If you pay the month-to-month plan, there is no cancellation fee because next month you cancel and you don't get charged. And the way they price the product, so here is the individual and business, and we're just going to go over the individual. So the pricing for Acrobat Pro. So this first option is annual paid monthly. This is the one that I signed up by mistake. So if the price is $19.99, you'll be paying $19.99 every month until you reach $239.88 for the year. So basically you sign up saying, I will pay the $239.88 for the entire year. Sign up the contract. That's what I did. And every month I'm going to just pay $19.99 because maybe, you know, you can't afford to pay everything at once. But I thought it was the monthly plan. I just quickly read it. I'm like, okay, monthly plan. Now, if you click on the annual prepaid plan, so this one, basically it's saying you pay one time $239.88, which is exactly what you pay for the annual paid monthly plan. So it's the same charge, but this one you have monthly charges to add up to that amount, and this one you just pay at once. So this one doesn't have a refund. This one has a cancellation fee. And then you also have this option for monthly. So for monthly, basically the charge will be $29.99. So every month you'll be paying this, and the difference between, you know, let's say this plan versus the annual plan, it's like $120. So it's for $30. If you from time to time you realize you need to edit a PDF, you have to pay $30 to get all these pro features available. So that's a lot. Some of the editors that I've been reviewing, they're much cheaper per month. Sometimes you can pay for $5. So is this shows you, for that summary that we looked, the first plan, there's no refund, and the last plan, there's no refund, but then there's a cancellation fee if you have that annual monthly. And let's calculate the cancellation fee. So when you go to the cancellation detail, here it explains how the cancellation fee is calculated. After 14 days, a cancellation fee, early termination fee of 50% of the remaining balance of the contract. So the way it's calculated, you have to, let's say after 1 month, in my case, it was like 2 months, I wanted to cancel this contract and I was going to be charged almost $100 because it says it will add up all the charges until the end of the contract that are still remaining and take 50% of that. So that will be $99. Then let's say if you wanted to do it halfway, then it will be just the remaining charges times 50%. And so right now I was $750, and the reason why it's $750, not $10, because my negotiated contract was $14.99. So you see, if I'm canceling right now, I have month and a half pretty much left. So I'll be paying $750. But you can see at the very beginning, there's just huge cancellation fee. That's why at that point, you don't want to do that because you feel like, wait a minute, might as well just have the product and not pay the cancellation fee. Let's say I want to continue with this cancellation. Now, what's interesting, now they do offer me these great deals, which is like for 60 days, you'll be $0. So I have 2 months with $0. Now, what happens is at that time, I still have to remember to cancel because then I will go back to being charged. What is it, $14.99 now, or will it be $19.99? I don't know. Will they remind me? Probably not. So I would have to put it on my calendar somewhere. Hey, cancel this plan maybe 2 days before, you know, the date comes. And then I'm just looking at some of these options here. You see, now they're giving me even better offer. So you have to go through this cancellation process in order to even get to this better deal, like for someone who's just not using it much. And I'll just say no thanks. And now it's telling me, well, guess what? You'll be charged this early termination fee. And if I say confirm, that it will be final. But I'll just cancel right now, close, because I have just 1 month left. And they're saying, oh, hurrah, you stayed with us. Great. But this really tells you that you have to be careful when you read some of these options. And this really happened to me, like I said, last year, January, because if I go to my billing, and that was another thing that I didn't like. When I went to my billing and I tried to find out, okay, let me see when's the end of my contract. I open my invoice, and on the invoice, it does not specify when it will end. It just says, for this month, this is what you're paying. I wish they could just specify the end of the contract will be then, so I can anticipate, versus like, I don't know. I had to like figure out on my own pretty much when it would end. I've seen that now, since then, some companies doing this annual paid monthly, but that at that time, year ago, that was the first time that I saw it. So I was really not reading it carefully because previously there was always this option, monthly or annual. But now you have annual pricing paid monthly. So hopefully you don't make that mistake that I've made. And then, you know, you sign up for something, even let's say they give you this deal, and before you know it's half a year and you've been paying something additional $19.99. Thanks so much for watching.